NATO. Have you heard of what it is? NATO. Several years ago, my friend says that it stands for No Action, Talk Only. NATO. I don't think Christianity is to be NATO. Christianity is not empty talk. If you are a Christian, you are born again, and there is to be a living faith in you that results in authentic spiritual life and growth. So, true Christian faith is to be expressed in our lives. You say, how? In what ways? I see three things mentioned in James 1, verses 26 to 27. First of all, a born-again man and a true child of God will have changes in his speech. In his speech. Because he says, if any man among you seem to be religious and bridleth not his tongue. So, real faith results in a change of our speech. And in this verse, I think it's not so much what we say, but what we don't say. It means we do not give in to vengeful, angry remarks. But we forgive. And we do not bite back or hurt others with our words. In this day and age, we must watch not only our actual speech, but also the things we say on our social medias and our SMSs. Isn't it true that we see a lot of bad blood on social media and SMSs, and that's not healthy? That's not right from a child of God. Now, of course, God is gracious, and we all know that we are in a process of sanctification, but let these things be a reminder to you that true faith results in a change of our, number one, speech. Number two, true faith results in service. He says, James says, that pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this, that we will visit the fatherless and widows in their affliction. True faith means that we would serve out of an unconditional love. We serve those who can't repay us. It's easy to be nice and kind and helpful to those who may be an asset, who may be a help to us in the future. And somehow there's that ulterior motive there. But true faith means I'm going to serve the fatherless, the orphans, the widows, who, humanly speaking, have no chance to repay us. But you see, that's what true faith is. We serve not because of who people are, but we serve because of who God is, who our Father is. We serve others because our Father serves and loves them. So true faith results in a change of our speech, in a change of our service, and finally in a change which results in separation. It says, lastly, in verse 27, to keep himself unspotted from the world. It will not be tainted or corrupted by the ways of the world. True faith means that we would not be like the world, or we would not aspire or dream to be like the world. We would serve the world, by the way, the widows, the orphans, but we will not imitate them. We will not hanker and lust after health and wealth and things that the world chase for. We will seek first the kingdom of God. We are not like the world, where we will love or we'll indulge in the lust of the flesh, the eyes, and the pride of life, but we'll love God. We'll not continue in sin, but we'll love God alone. A man who truly loves God will keep himself unspotted from the world. No action, talk only, does not belong to a true child of God. He will change. He will grow in his speech, in his service, and in separation. May these things be means by which you can examine and encourage your hearts. God bless.